Hey, what's up guys, this is Mario, and in today's video, I'm gonna talk about how to pay off your student loans fast so you can avoid paying unnecessary interest. Now, you guys are probably wondering, what is going on over here? Well guys, this is Oaxacan Textile Mexican Art, and if you stick to the end, I'll explain to you more what this art means. I bought this piece in Chapala, Mexico, and I'm gonna explain to you why this is important at the end of the video. So stick around guys, back to the video. So let's talk about student loans. I was actually very fortunate to graduate from Northern Illinois University with a bachelor's degree in finance. And when I graduated, I did have student loans. Now, I came from the mentality, just growing up with my family, my parents, that debt was bad. So when I graduated, I worked my butt off to pay that off as soon as possible. And there's a lot to that that I learned from paying that off and how I saved a lot of money and interest. But there's more to it, guys. The reason why paying off student loans is so important is because you cannot get rid of student loans. You cannot even get rid of student loans even if you file bankruptcy, guys. Student loans are pretty much like taxes. The government will go after you, whatever it takes to get that money back. Now, if you stop paying your student loans, the government may even garnish your wages. That means they, by law, they could actually start taking money out of your paycheck to pay your student loans because you didn't pay it. So guys, in this video, I'm gonna teach you guys what steps you should take to pay that student loan as soon as possible so you can save a whole bunch of money in interest and also pay it off sooner than 10 years. And this could definitely set you up for success for the rest of your life. So don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much for your support, guys. All right, guys, let's get started. Just so you guys know, the average student loan in the United States is around $30,000. And the average length of repayment is around 10 years. And now at a 6% interest, that means that the average student is gonna pay around $10,000 in interest over the lifetime of that loan. The problem happens is when students actually end up paying only the minimum payment, which is $50. And when students do that, when students pay only the $50 minimum payment, your original student loan of maybe $30,000 could balloon up to $50, $60, $70, even $80,000, guys. All right, guys. So what I'm going to do really quickly is give you an example of how things could go wrong when you start paying a bare minimum in your student loan. So I'm going to show you how to get this app. So if you want to go to the Apple Store and search for student loan calculator, and you'll see this little student loan calculator with the white hat. This is the one that you want to download. It should be for free. And now what I've already kind of inputted is numbers. The numbers are, I did put $30,000, again, like I mentioned before, $30,000 is the average student loan debt in the United States with around average 6% interest. And the repayment period is 10 years. That is the average repayment period. So if you press calculate, this says that your monthly payment, in order for you to pay your student loan in 10 years, your monthly payment is going to be $333.06. And if you see this red numbers, that means that you're gonna be paying $9,967 in interest, in total interest. And if you look at the right-hand corner, that $39,967, that is the total cost of your student loan over that 10 period. So when you borrow $30,000, you will be paying a total cost of $39,967 over a 10-year period. Now, if you scroll down, you'll see the amortization graph. It's actually really, really cool. Now, I'm gonna give an example of what happens when you do end up paying less than the required amount to pay it in 10 years. What happens is your loan duration is gonna go up. So, to give an example, your loan duration could be 20 years instead of 10 years. So if you're paying $50 a month, it could go up to like 40 years or more. But this is an example. Instead of paying $333 a month to pay it off in 10 years and you decide to maybe pay $200 a month, you will end up paying $21,583 in interest. And so your total cost overall is gonna be $51,000. So it gets worse over time. So let's say you end up paying less than $200. So let's say that you end up paying only like $180 a month. That means it's gonna take you around, it should take you around 30 years to pay your student loan. And you're gonna be paying a total interest of $34,752.
So the total cost of your loan is going to be $64,752. So the original $30,000 that you actually borrowed to pay for college now is gonna cost you double the money because you decided to pay less than the amount needed to pay off your loan in 10 years. So this is where students get in trouble, guys. This is where things could go very, very wrong with student loans. So how do you avoid that? How do you change that? How do you eliminate that issue? So this is what you do. So again, your original plan is 10 years. That's the average original plan, 10 years. So my recommendation is to make additional payments. So let's say that you decide, you know what? I got extra money in my pocket. I'm not gonna go to the bar this weekend. I'm gonna save myself $100 for the month so I could pay that towards my student loans. So if you make an additional $100 payment every single month on your student loans, you will actually, so I guess your monthly payment will be $433.06. You're actually gonna pay less interest. You're gonna pay $6,921, which is less than $10,000. So you're gonna save, this is right here in green, interest saved. You're gonna save $3,046 in interest, and you're gonna be paying your student loan 2 years or 2.83 years earlier. So a little bit over 2 years and a half earlier. So instead of 10 years, you're gonna be paying your student loan around 7 years and a half, which is pretty nice. So let's say that you say, hey, you know what? I'm gonna give $200 extra on my student loan to pay it up even faster. Maybe you stop going out to the bars on the weekends, but maybe you stop going out to eat. And you press the calculate button, and whoa, voila, now of course you're gonna be paying a lot more. So you're gonna be paying around $532.06 a month. But yeah, you're only gonna be paying a total interest of $5,317. You will be saving $4,650 in interest. This is money saved. And you will be paying your student loan in 4 years and 4.42 months, which is around 4 years and 3 months around there, or 4 years and 4 months, something like that. So instead of 10 years, you're gonna be paying your student loan around 5 years and 4 months. 5 years and 4 months. That's pretty nice, guys, okay? And again, it keeps going on and on. So the more additional money you pay upfront towards your student loans, the faster you're gonna be paying your student loans and the more money you're gonna be saving. So I'm gonna put 300 just to kind of see what happens. If you decide, you know what? I'm gonna stop spending money on things I do not need, so I'm not gonna be spending money on wants. I wanna pay off the student loan as soon as possible. So every additional extra money to have that I will usually spend on wants, like going out to eat, buying things I don't really need, I'm just gonna put them to my student loans, man. Let's see what happens. So if you do that, your monthly payment, of course, you would be paying around $633 a month. Your total interest will be $4,325. So that's the total interest you're gonna be paying from the $30,000 you borrow. You will be saving $5,643 in that period, and you will be saving 5 years and 5.42 years saved. So that means that you will be paying your loan in around 4 years and a little bit over 4 years and a half. So that is the secret, guys. That is the secret to paying off your student loans as soon as possible. It does come with sacrifice. I'm not gonna lie, guys. It's gonna take some sacrifices. But the truth is, guys, you have two options. You either could make more income, meaning you could work extra hours, do some overtime, or maybe get a part-time job or a side hustle to make extra money to pay down the student loans, or you can make some sacrifices. So instead of spending money on things that you don't need, on wants, like going out on the weekend, spending money in restaurants or on drinks or entertainment, you could use that money to pay off your student loan.
Yes, now for those of you guys who need some help budgeting, who have no idea, hey, where am I gonna get this extra money to pay down my student loans based on my current budget? I don't wanna get an extra job. I don't really have time for that. Where can I get the extra money so I could pay down my student loans? So I created this video, guys, how to budget your money, the 50-30-20 rule of money, where it talks about your needs, your wants, and your savings and investments, and how you could budget your money so you can find extra money to pay down your student loans. Now I'm gonna put a little link. You will see a little pop-up link on the right-hand corner. Just click on the link and it'll take you to watch that video. Well guys, I wanna quickly thank you for sticking all the way to the end, but as promised, I'm gonna talk about this art piece and what it represents. Well guys, this is a traditional Oaxacan textile art. This scene actually depicts the Aztecs and the founding of the city of Tenochtitlan. Well guys, you guys may be wondering, what is the city of Tenochtitlan? The city of Tenochtitlan is actually modern day Mexico City. So pretty much legend has it that the Aztecs were following the prophecy of the god of sun and war. Prophecy stated that when they found an eagle sitting on top of a cactus eating a snake, that will be the spot where they should settle to build their new city in the city of Tenochtitlan. Modern day Mexico City was founded on this prophecy. This amazing, beautiful prophecy of the Aztecs finding the eagle sitting atop the cactus eating a snake. And that is modern day Mexico, guys. So as you guys can see, guys, we have the eagle right here. We got the cactus. Now, the only thing that's missing here is actually the snake. But if you guys see the Mexican flag, you will see the eagle and the snake in the mouth and the cactus. So that's where that comes from. So now you guys will understand why that is really important. The other reason why I'm bringing this up, guys, is that I'm actually going to Mexico City in January. So I'm very, very excited. I'm gonna create a lot of videos. They cover art, history, culture of Mexico City. And I'm also gonna combine it with finance. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. So hopefully look forward to that because I'm actually very excited to do that. Appreciate if you guys make some comments, subscribe to the channel, could hashtag watch until the end. It will really help the YouTube algorithm and it will really help support the channel to grow. Thank you very much, guys. Appreciate it. Till next time.